Welcome to Pig's Pod. I am Oreo. Oreo.
And I am Q stick.
No, we shouldn't really make fun of stuttering.
Oh, oops. I didn't realize that's what we were doing. Some legends are told, some turn to dust or to gold, but you will remember me. Remember me for centuries. Just one mistake is all it will take. We'll go down in history. Remember me for centuries.
Episode 22, Things to Come, Pig's Pod. And I am Oreo.
I'm Q-Stick.
Q-Stick, same. Is that your theme song? You should have a personal theme song. We need to make it. Personal theme song.
I could probably figure it out.
Q-Stick's a dick.
Da-na-na-na-na-na. Dun. Yeah, something like that.
Okay, so we need to, like, talk about, I don't know. I don't know how to talk about what happened last week, Q. I feel like we got molested. Do you feel that? Is it in the air? Is it just me?
Maybe it's just you. What? Show me on the doll where they touched you.
Right here. They touched the naughty spot. And he told me not to tell anybody that if I told anybody, I would be in trouble. And he'd kill my daddy. He touched me, though. But I kind of liked it.
Jesus, Oreo. Wow.
Oh, I feel, I don't, like.
What makes you feel like you were
molested? I feel like I was molested. I feel like I was in a room with things going on that I didn't want to happen. Maybe not molested. Maybe I feel like I witnessed a molesting. Like, I witnessed Star Wars, the topic, get molested to death, you guys needed the Star Wars dough way beyond anything it ever needed. You needed to stop and let it rise, but you wouldn't. You kept pounding the dough into the table and just...
Okay.
I don't know. That's the best analogy I can come up with what I feel of what happened. Not that it was a bad thing. It was just extremely deep.
Well, that's what we were trying.
A deep triple fisting of Star Wars right in front of me. And I, eyes wide, just watched as we talked about creatures with elephant trunks giving blowjobs. things we didn't even get to, like why Chewie doesn't jerk off. For two reasons, he's too hairy. And he rips people's arms off. I mean, that's all I need to say. You get too excited and go and rip that thing off.
Yeah, I did get kind of excited, that's for sure.
I don't know. I don't know. Did you have fun on the last one yet? It was all right. It wasn't.
Oh, I had a great time.
I feel like you guys... I got like a mental picture I didn't want to see. I don't know. I feel like you guys tied me down, even though I wasn't tied down, but it felt like I was, like I couldn't leave the room, and I had to witness, I don't know how to say it, whatever. It just went way beyond anything I could ever understand, or even begin to understand. Half the characters you guys were talking about, I don't know who the hell they are.
I'm sorry.
I wasn't kidding when I got excited that he mentioned whatever her name is, the elephant chick, and he said the lipstick. I was like, I know who that is. I know who that is. And then he mentioned blowjob. I was like, well, I know what he's talking about. freaking long episode.
Yeah, now that it was. It was really long.
I don't think we'll ever go that long again. Promise. I hope not.
That was a little long.
But we need to get to what we didn't get to talk about on that episode, which was video games. We touched on it like a little bit. We touched the doll in the naughty spots a little bit. But we resisted temptation of going off on the video game path. So I wanted to talk about it. Because people need to know. Because more than a year ago now, Q, EA bought the rights to Star Wars video games, LucasArts, as it were. And I didn't even know this until a couple days before we did last episode. I didn't even know. And we never got to talk about it. So now Skills is in the dark. And he was asking me a lot about, like, Battlefront, like, after or outside of the podcast, he's asking me about, like, Battlefront and, like, other Star Wars games. I was like, yeah, dude, there's 3 Star Wars games coming. So we're going to talk about those, kind of. If you were on the Facebook page at all recently, I put up a teaser kind of trailer for Battlefront 3, which looks incredible. I wish I was watching it and I was thinking, I can't wait until games look this good as you're playing, not just in the trailers, because it looks freaking sexy in the trailer. I don't know if you watched it, Q, for Battlefront 3.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, it looks so sexy, right?
Looks, that was amazing.
I hope the game looks like that, but I'm pretty sure it won't. I mean, as far as I know, because DICE is the one making Battlefront 3, I don't know if we said, but as far as I know, they're using their Frostbite engine to power Battlefront. Dude, it's going to be so destructible Star Wars environments. Destroy the Rebel base. You can literally destroy the Rebel base. It's going to be good. Vehicles. I don't know. Battlefield has never been that good at vehicles, though. So I'm a little worried about how they're going to do that. How they're going to handle the speeders and the... What do you call the... I don't know. You know all the names to the ships, Q. What are the ones... That, oh my god, I feel like an idiot.
Describe it to me.
The ones, it's like a half wing, and it has the 2 laser shooters coming out the front, and it drops out a tie cable, and they tie it around.
The air speeders.
Yeah.
They were modified for Hoth for the snow speeders.
Yeah, the snow speeders, whatever. Those were in the trailer, so I'm assuming they're gonna be in the game, but I don't know. Like I said, Battlefield's never been that great. They've never been that great at ground vehicles. I'll give them props on their air vehicles. I like flying jets and planes in Battlefield. So, I guess I'm not worried about those. But more ground. I mean, I can't even think of that many ground vehicles other than, like, pods. What do they call those, Q? Not the pod racers. Not the pod racers, though.
Not the pod racers.
The slower ones. The everyday driving vehicles of the Star Wars universe.
Yes, they're just called speeders.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
They're just speeders.
I hate to burst your bubble on that one.
All right, I thought there was like a name, a fancy name that actually meant something. Nope, just speeders. Those, I don't know. I don't know how they're going to fill in Battlefront. I don't know. We'll see. But anyways, they have released like an official, whatever you call it, official teaser kind of talking about Battlefront. And this is one of the main guys at DICE, and I think he actually recently said this at GDC. He said the game's campaign will focus mainly on the original trilogy of films, but there will be parts of the prequels thrown in. Like Jar Jar. No, I'm just kidding. He didn't say Jar.
Watch your mouth.
Well, what if you can kill him, though? Would you want him in?
No, I don't want him in at all.
You don't want to kill him? You don't?
No, I just don't want him in there at
That's
all.
That's just how the game starts, just Jar Jar. Hey, it's a me, Jar Jar.
Yeah.
Just fucking lay him down and then the title screen comes up and it goes Battlefront 3 and fuck Jar Jar.
Yeah, all together. Like, don't even, not at all. he didn't exist. It's kind of like the Midichlorians. They just don't exist.
The coolest part of what he said, though, the final part of the campaign is due to be a prequel to Star Wars Episode 7. And they've said the game will come out a little bit. They haven't said how much a little bit is, but a little bit before the movie releases. And do we even have an official like movie release date for that? I should look that up.
Yes, you should, because I figure it'll be in. It'll either be a June or a December release.
I just tried to type in Battlefront movie. Idiot. Star Wars 7 movie release date. The Force Awakens, 2015. Oh, December 18th, 2015. So that means, shoot, that could, anything before December 8th. I mean, probably in November, I guess, is probably when Battlefront will come out. That's normally when they release the big holiday games. So now, here's the thing I wanted to get to on Battlefront. Okay, DICE is making it. They've made Battlefield. How do you even feel on Battlefield, Q? I want to ask you that first.
How do I feel about Battlefield?
Yeah, how do you feel about Battlefield?
It's a shooter.
yeah.
I mean, it's
a shooter.
It is what it is.
So you're not a fan?
Well, I'm not really a fan. I mean,
it's better than Call of Duty, right? We can agree
with
that.
Yeah, it's better than Call of Duty, but I mean, okay. That's, you know, it's relative.
It's a relative?
Yeah, it's relative.
Well, the campaign sucks, so I'm hoping they don't go that way with Battlefront. But I'm worried about the multiplayer for Battlefront, because they're already, and they're having what's called an aggressive DLC plan. They're planning 5 content packs already with several new maps each, which makes it sound exactly like that Battlefield premium bullshit. Okay, buy the game for $60. And, you know, you're not broke enough already. I mean, Christmas is coming up in a couple of weeks. You probably have another $50 to give us, right? Just so you can save, like, $5 over time for the content packs.
Yeah, see, I'm against DLC as it is, so.
Yeah, and they've already said they're planning 5 with a few new maps each. So I'm kind of worried about how the multiplayer is going to play out. So I hope it has a good campaign. I hope the multiplayer doesn't suck. I don't know. It's a toss-up, because I want to be in the Star Wars world and have destructible environments, blow shit up, destroy the fuck out of Hoth. I'm excited, but I'm also worried because DICE has it. Not that DICE makes bad games. They're just controlled by EA, who likes money and saving up on all the shit instead of just releasing a game. Wouldn't you rather go like World of Warcraft route, where they just give you fucking tons of shit and they just make you pay monthly?
No, I would like to pay $60 and have a complete game.
And have your game?
Yeah, I really would.
Well, that's not going to work. Games cost too much money. Look at Destiny. It costs $500 million to make. They're not going to make that back selling $60 at a time.
As much as it pains me to say it, I wouldn't mind having DLC if say, you know, the DLC was, you know, maybe $5.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't have a problem with that. But I mean, Jesus fuck. I mean, $30-some, $40-some for, you know, when it's all said and done and the game is done and they're no longer putting out, you know, packs for it.
Yeah,
you put $200 or $300 into a game.
Yeah.
I'm like, no, I'm sorry. I know that this game is gonna sell fairly well. It probably won't be a blockbuster, but it'll be a decent game and it'll probably do better than average. So that means there's better than average number of people have bought this game. Divide that number by the cost of what it takes to create that game. I guarantee it's not no $300. I guarantee it's not.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I understand their overhead, but it's stupid.
But it is nice to have expansions to like a game that you like, being able to keep playing it.
Yeah, that's
fine. I don't like when it's like, okay, Gears of War is the first one that really bugged me in this field, because the DLC, the expansions, the extra skins, I'm talking Gears of War 3, and Judgment, all the extra shit, the downloadable content, like 60% of that shit was on the disc. And you had to pay a fee to unlock that shit. It's like, it's on the disc.
Yeah, I'm against
that. You're literally
that.
Just trying to get... I don't mind giving you more money when it's worth it. You're expanding the universe that I enjoy being in. But fucking... If I wanted to just sit and waste money on a game, I'd play Farmville, you know?
Right.
I think... I don't know what Farmville is. But anyways, moving on. We can't talk about Battlefront all day, because there's 2 other Star Wars games. You know who BioWare is, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay, well, BioWare was already working under EA on Star Wars games. They made the Old Republic video games, and they're working on another video game, Star Wars. And so I'm guessing it's another Old Republic sequel. I don't know how much you got into the old old Republic games and all, but...
I didn't play them all that much. I did do a little bit with the MMO online. I just didn't really get into it.
Yeah, me neither. I mean, it looks good. I hear it's awesome. I don't know, I'm not really that excited for it. But it, apparently there's another one coming. So there you go. If you're excited for it, don't jizz in your pants, I guess. Visceral Games, though. This is the one I'm excited for. Because Visceral took the... They hired the lady, you know the Uncharted series, right? For PlayStation?
Yes.
That's super huge, and apparently, I've never played it, but apparently has an amazing storyline. Well, they hired the main chick that wrote all the stories. Well, I mean, it wasn't just her writing it, but she was on the writing team. They hired her, and now she's working for EA at Visceral, working on a Star Wars game.
Right.
Now, the only details I can find is that it's a third-person shooter spin-off story. Now, I'm thinking they're going to go with 1313, but I'm not positive. They might just take the assets from it. I mean, because they had a lot of that game done already, and they might just rewrite the story. And instead, what a lot of fans have been begging for is a Han Solo backstory. And I know there is either a movie or a TV show that's a Han Solo backstory that's coming. So I wouldn't be surprised if they have a video game to go along with it. But like I said, that's all I know. Third person spin-off story. I don't know. I know you want 1313 like it was.
Oh, yeah.
I know Bounty Hunters are a big deal to Q. I mean, if you've seen any of his Facebook pictures, you have a full, what's it called? I'm sorry.
Mandalorian armor.
See, I was going to say mandolin, but that's wrong.
That's close.
Isn't that the instrument you play?
Yes.
Oh, well, that'd be cool if you had a mandolin suit. You put it on, it's got strings going down it. Never mind.
Lasai.
1313. I don't know if they're going to keep that or not. This one, again, it looks like how it's going. EA is planning to go not quite Call of Duty with it, but almost. Because Call of Duty has, what, 3 studios working on it now, and they release a game every month. Or, not every month. That'd be nice.
Freudian slip.
Every year. And it kind of looks like that's what EA's planning with Star Wars games. They have 3 studios now. They have DICE, they have BioWare, and they have Visceral, all working on Star Wars games. And I imagine they're going to renew contracts. So this year's Battlefront. Next year, I imagine since 1313 was almost done, and I imagine that's probably what they took a majority of the assets from. I'm thinking that's what's coming next year. And Old Republic 3 or whatever the hell, I guess that would be 2017. And then again, it would go back to DICE for a Battlefront 4 or whatever in 2018. I imagine that's how they're going to do it. But again, I don't know. Anyways, that's what we wanted to kind of talk about, get to on last week's podcast, and we didn't, unfortunately. We're getting to it now. There you go. Now you know. 3 Star Wars games coming, 1 a year for the next 3 years at least. After that, who knows? I mean, I don't know the movie schedule, how often they're going to try and release those. But as long as there's new, like my son, I guarantee he'll be into Star Wars as he grows up. So, I mean, literally, they could go forever. The Star Wars universe is so vast. I mean, just go listen to the last 2.5 hours on the last podcast, and you'll see how vast it really is.
Oh, my, yeah.
Okay, moving on. Now, I want to talk about games that are coming this year, other than the Battlefront. So, if you're listening to this on Thursday, like you should, there are 3 games already out this week. Ori and the Blind Forest. Have you heard anything about that, Q?
No clue.
Oh, have you ever heard of Limbo?
Yes.
The arcade game? Okay. Mm-hmm. Imagine that. But instead of black and white, imagine it amazing and colorful, and the graphics literally melt your dick off.
Okay, well, that sounds disturbing.
It looks and plays a lot like Limbo, but like I said, it's super colorful, and it's the same kind of thing, though. It's like a side-scroller thing like Limbo. You play as like a little creature that almost looks like if Sonic had, like, instead of being a fully evolved hedgehog, he came out as like an embryo. That sounds fucked up, but that's what the Ori thing looks like in Ori and the Blind Forest. And that just came out today, like today as we're recording this podcast. So that's out now.
Nice.
It looks freaking, it looks good though. This is, I wish I had an unlimited budget. I would just buy up all these games because Ori and the Blind Forest looks fucking fun, dude. It reminds me of, Abe's Odyssey. I don't know if you ever played Abe's Odyssey way back in the day.
No, that I played that one.
It looks fun, like puzzles, side scroller, super colorful. It, but seriously, dude, the graphics look amazing from the gameplay that I watched. Now, again, you know how they are when they put gameplay and trailers and shit up on YouTube. They fancy it up, and you never know what the actual game's gonna look like. But the stuff that I watched on YouTube looks like a movie. Like, I bet I could buy this game and sit down, and my son would sit and watch it like it's a movie. Because it looks like a fucking Pixar movie.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It looks... I don't know. You'd have to look it up and see it. It's out now on Xbox Live Arcade. It's an arcade title. I think it's $20. I'm not positive, though. Don't quote me on that. Look it up. Go get it. Another game that's out that just came out... Well, no, it didn't come out today. I think it came out today in Japan, maybe. But it's coming out in U.S. on Thursday, which is when you would listen to this. Which is weird for a video game to come out on a Thursday. But that's what the thing said. I'm just telling you the news. Mario Party 10. I know you know what Mario Party is, Q.
Yeah. Can't say that I've played it much, but yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Mario Party 10 on Wii U. It looks pretty fun. I mean, they boasted something like 60 new mini games or whatever. So what, now Mario Party has a mini game library of like 8,000?
Something like that.
Something like that. I don't know. It looks like Mario Party, but newer graphics, newer mini games. I don't know. It looks fun for my son, who's 2, but for me, who's 26, I don't have a Wii U either, but, you know, it's out. If you have a Wii U, there you go, Mario Party 10. Go for it. Dark Souls 2, which, honestly, I've never been into Dark Souls. It doesn't, like, for being as new as it is, Skyrim looks, feels, plays better. And to me, when I look at Dark Souls, it reminds me of Skyrim, but it looks like a shittier version. It doesn't look that fun to me. And all I've heard is complaints about it, that it's super hard. I don't know what that means, but I've heard nothing but bad things about it. But if you're into Dark Souls, it's out now. Right now. Go to the store. Go to Walmart. Go get it. Did okay, you go get it, Q? I was waiting for you to go get it and tell me if it's good or not.
Yeah, it was awesome.
It's good? Okay. Well, there you go. Q said it's good, Dark Souls 2. And speaking of Battlefield, like we did earlier, Battlefield Hardline.
I'm sorry, what?
Battlefield Hardline.
Oh, yeah.
It's not out right now. It's coming out March 17th, next week. So in a few days after you listen to this, Battlefield Hardline. Ba-bum. Bum-bum, cops versus robbers. Bum-bum. Dude, you can flip off cops and shit in this. You can flip people off. The robbers talk shit about the cops all the time. Other than that, it's Battlefield. I know what... I was watching some gameplay, and one of the robbers is like, oh, that fucking cop ratted us out. Let's go fucking kill him, dude. Like, what? They literally talk... like. If you're on the robber team, or I don't want to keep calling them robbers, cops and robbers, I guess. If you're on the robber team, they literally talk shit about the cops, like the whole, I guess the cops do too. Oh, you piece of shit, robber. I don't think they call them robbers. You piece of shit, robber. I don't know. It's Battlefield. It has some new shit, new guns, new game modes, but it's Battlefield. It's nothing amazing. If you're into Battlefield, go get it. I'm just not that into Battlefield. For the way shooters go, there's shooters I'd rather play. Destiny for one. Q.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that more next week. Q finally has it. He's played it.
Yeah, so I've got a week to do my Q review.
Q review coming next week of Destiny. It's his Destiny. It's been your Destiny since we started this podcast to play Destiny, Q.
Yeah, apparently.
It's good, right? It's not that bad.
It's not. I mean, you know, I'll talk about it more when we do the episode, but, okay. You know, it's, I knew going into the game, I had a certain expectation of what this game was going to be.
Yeah.
And it met the expectation. It didn't exceed the expectation. It didn't fall short of the expectation. And the expectation, like, wasn't, like, negative or, like, oh, this could be a stupid game. No. It has, you know, it had nothing like that at all. It was just, like, I knew what style this game was going to be before I played it. And it was exactly that.
And it was that style.
Yeah, there's nothing negative or derogatory towards it. I mean, it's an MMO. It's what it is. And if I'm actually really excited that, you know, console gamers are getting a good taste of a good MMO. I mean, it is, for what it is, it's a good game. You know, it's not as, like, soul-stripping as other MMOs that I've played. You know, I sat and I played it for, I think I've got, I guess somewhere around maybe 40 to 50 hours invested in it.
Yeah.
And I'm a level 24, 25 now.
See.
So, I mean.
Yeah. We'll talk about it more next week. Review. I like that. Review.
Cue review.
There you go. How about, fighting games? How do you feel about fighting games?
I haven't played a good fighting game since, like, I mean, I just haven't played very much of it. Oops, sorry about that. I didn't mean to kick the mic. But I haven't played a good fighting game since, like, Super Nintendo. Because, I mean,
What was your fighting game back in the day?
Back in the day was Mortal Kombat. I played the fuck out of Mortal Kombat 3 Ultimate.
Ooh, Mortal, like, Kombat. So
Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3.
So you're excited for the new Mortal Kombat, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's a Mortal Kombat game. I mean, it's...
No, it's not. It looks fucking... Have you seen it, Cue?
Yeah, it looks great. It looks awesome. You know, everything about it looks good. It looks like, you know, a Mortal Kombat game that they've, you know, brought up to par with new graphics and new shit and new characters and, you know...
And X-ray vision and new...
Yeah.
New fucking... We'll get to it in a second. Mortal Kombat X is the game we're talking about. April 14th is when it drops. You know, while you were talking, I think I figured it out why we don't get as excited for games. It's because they cost money. I'm broke. Are you broke? We're broke.
Yeah.
Broke ass bitches.
I spent it all on podcasting stuff.
We don't have game or money for games anymore. It's not like when you're a kid and that you're way excited because the money means nothing to you. It's just purely the game. It's a different experience when you're fucking, you're as old as Q and I, and all you see in the game is how much money you spent on it. I think once you reach that point of, like, yeah, this was worth the $60, then you enjoy the game. But it's a few hours into you playing it, I think.
Right.
I don't think it's ever the second, like, when you were a kid and you open up that, oh my God. I remember, like, when I was a kid and my mom surprised me and hid Need for Speed Underground.
Nice, old school.
In the car. And she's like, oh, I think I forgot something out there. And I went and found, I was like, oh, like, little kid boner. Like, Need for Speed. It's, I don't know, it's different. You look through it through different eyes, through innocent eyes that don't see money signs. Sounds like an Eminem song or something, but it's different. So, like, I'm excited for Mortal Kombat, but I'm almost not because I don't know if I'll have the money to buy it. Even if I will have the money to buy it, will I spend it on that, or will I spend it on a different game, or Destiny, or DLC, or will I spend it on hookers, or...
you know, whatever you gotta do, right?
Yeah, so, I don't know, it looks freaking... I was watching today, again, the, Fatality video. I'll have to put it up on Facebook. Facebook.com/PixPod. The fatalities, though. Oh my God, dude. They look so brutal. I guess is the word. They look insane, dude. They went way... I don't even know how they got this game approved to be on the market with some of the shit they have now. And the graphics are so much better. And just like... what's the... chick's name, the Asian chick, purple get up.
Purple is Melina.
Melina, okay. I watched her fatality. Brutal, dude. Literally throws a dude down to the ground, whips out her fans that are actually blades.
Now her fan, if it's,
is that a different chick?
Well, yeah, the fans is Katana. Melina okay. had the size.
See, I thought it was Katana, but I...
Yeah, Melina was in purple, Katana was in blue.
Oh, I thought she was in purple during the video. Maybe she, maybe it was blue. Maybe I wanted it to be purple. But anyway, she whips out her fans, and she just shoves one over the dude's neck and the other over his eye sockets and just pushes down and fucking scuts it. Cuts his skull into two pieces and leaves his head in two pieces laying on the ground and his skull just gushing blood. Like, oh, it was sexy. It was nice. Katana and the fan blades. It looks sick. What's the... See, I haven't played Mortal Kombat in a long time. I forget all their names. Raiden?
Raiden.
His was freaking... Oh, it was cool. It was bad. I don't want to ruin all of them and sit here and talk about them all day. I'll put the video up. You can go watch them. It looks good. I don't know how much the game is going to cost. I don't know if it's an arcade game or a full $60 game. I hope it's not a full $60 game. I don't remember the last time Mortal Kombat was a full $60 game.
I know it was back on the Super Nintendo, and I think it was on the 64, but I haven't really played any of the games since the N64.
Yeah, I think, well, I don't know. I hope it's just arcade title, but anyways, Mortal Kombat. How do you feel about Tekken?
Tekken, that was a Sega game, wasn't it? Wasn't that on the Sega series or the Sega line?
Yeah, and I think Microsoft bought them out.
Well, that shows how far back I've gone with Tekken. So
yeah, well, Tekken 7 is coming out, and Tekken 7's graphics actually look better than Mortal Kombat's graphics. But I still prefer Mortal Kombat over Tekken. Oh, Tekken's more—I don't know. Towards anime, if you're into anime stuff. I mean, I like anime, but when you compare fatalities to just beating the shit out of people, when you could beat the shit out of people and do fatalities, I mean, maybe there's more to Tekken that I'm not remembering, but I don't know. I prefer Mortal Kombat. But anyways, Tekken 7, it doesn't have an official release date, but I do know there's a Tekken tournament later this month on the 20th, and they said Tekken 7 will be available there. And they said it should be coming out in stores soon after that. So I'm imagining the 24th for Tekken 7, if that's what you're into, 24th of March. Look for it in stores, whatever. Moving on. Witcher 3. Have you played the Witcher series?
No, I haven't.
Well, I've played a little bit with my cousin of Witcher 2. And it's another one that kind of feels, I don't know, I kind of compare all these games to Skyrim as an open world, like, MMORPG, is that what you would call it, I guess?
Yeah, kind of.
Because Skyrim's the only one that I really got into and played a lot and enjoyed. So I kind of compare all these to Skyrim, and Witcher 3 looks like a Skyrim updated, better graphics, looks like it has a cool story. The voice acting doesn't suck, in the trailer at least. Yeah, it looks interesting. There was one scene that I saw in the trailer with a girl that popped up and had like these yellow beady eyes that was really creepy. And my wife was actually watching it with me, and she's like, and I turned it off and she got pissed. Yeah, I was watching that. Like, the trailer looks good enough that it made me want to go get Witcher 3, but again, I don't have the money, but the trailer looked good enough that it looks interesting. Witcher 3, that's May 19th. I mean, we don't have much more else to say about it. Neither of us really played it, but the trailer looks good.
Yeah.
Here's Batman. Batman Q.
Batman?
Are you excited for Batman?
I'm a little excited for Batman.
A little excited?
You're more of a Spider-Man guy, but, you know, I can let it ride.
What the fuck?
Don't you judge me.
I like both. I'm a Batman and Spider-Man, and I'm not an Avengers guy. Are you an Avengers guy?
Well, I have to be because the wife is, but other than that, not really.
Okay, so you're just saying it. Okay. Batman, though, it looks good. The game looks good. This is one of those that look good that my mom's not buying me games for Christmas anymore, and I don't have the money to get all these games. I don't have the time to play all these games if I had the money to get all these games, because the time I use to try and get all the money to play all these games, I'm at work, so I don't have time to play the games.
Yeah, I know.
That's it. sucks being an adult, Q. I mean, can I just stay at home and you'll pay my bills and buy me games?
I wish I could do that. I've been trying that for years and they've been working.
God. This one's, and it's a $60 game. It's a full game. Batman Arkham Knight. Oh, it looks so good, though. The graphics look good. The gameplay looks good. It's rated M, so you know it's not a typical Batman. I guess there's one scene where you're cutting somebody up on a surgical table, I guess, and they said that wasn't good. I guess the game invented a new swear word, and that wasn't good. There was a couple other things that got him an M rating. I mean, there's Harley Quinn, I guess, has a little risque in it. So it's an M rating, so you know it's going to be good, Q.
Yeah, it'll be good.
June 2nd. There you go.
No, not bad.
Now, I want to ask you about this one.
Okay.
Did you ever hear of Homefront?
Homefront? Yeah, vaguely.
Came out in 2011.
Yeah.
It came out under THQ, I believe, and it was a shooter. They tried to create a new IP, a whole new story, like terrorists and the world was in chaos and everything's blowing up and planes are just falling out of the fucking sky and...
Right.
And you're at your home and you, and for some reason there's, I can't even remember the story. I remember playing it for like an hour and being like, this game fucking blows. And I got rid of it. Somehow, I almost believe that game is what bankrupt THQ, honestly. Because it looked good, but it was a pile of shite. And I guess when they actually filed bankruptcy, they lost rights to the Homefront game. And Crytek picked it up.
Okay.
And the new one, oh my God. Again, I don't know if this is just trailers on YouTube, but it looked like gameplay. So unless they're tricking me, because the way the movements and stuff look like gameplay, it looks fucking amazing, Q. I don't want to waste my money on another Homefront game, but it looks so good. It's called Homefront The Revolution. And there's no official release date on it, so I can't give you that. I mean, I tried looking it up on Amazon. It just says December 31st, 2015, which basically is Amazon just saying, sometime this year. I don't know when. But it looks so sexy. I'll have to put this up on Facebook, too. The dude is walking around, and it's like chaotic city. It's like when you think of a typical movie where everything's in chaos and the world's fucking in disarray and there's trash all over the place and there's cars all over the place and you're just trying to, you know, keep living after the apocalypse. It looks like that.
Right.
But better than Battlefield 4 graphics. The graphics looked incredible in the trailer I watched. One of the cool things that he did too, the dude walked up to like a rack in a gun store. And he was going through like scopes and different magazines and shit. And he pulled his gun out in front of him and looked down at it. And that's where you modify your fucking weapon, right there in front of you, as if you would in real life. He was sliding the scope off of his gun and sliding on a new scope. I don't know, just watching that, it was like sexy, Q. It gave me like a little nerdy gamer boner.
Nice, nice.
But it looks so good as he's like sliding on and off. And he was obviously playing it on the Xbox One because it said, like, push Y to change scope and shit like that. So you're holding the gun out underneath you in front of you. So it doesn't take you out to a fucking menu. You get to do it in real time in fucking first person view right underneath, just sliding on scopes and sliding on a new buttstock and fucking a new different magazine. And then he goes back to playing. Like, you don't go to fucking menus. It looks so good, Q. I'll put it up on Facebook. You'll have to watch it. It looks all right. Good. Again, cool. I don't know if it's mirrors and smoke and film trickery, but the graphics look good to me. I might have to save some money for all the games coming out this Christmas season because there's a lot of them. There's Halo 5. There's Homefront, which I might pick up. I don't know. The Division, which is coming out. Have you seen anything on that at least, Q? Division?
No.
The new, I want to say it was under Tom Clancy, wasn't it?
I don't know. Was it?
But that doesn't make sense because there's another Tom Clancy game that's supposed to be coming out this year. The Division. God, now I gotta go to Google and type in The Division, because I was excited for it, like, when they announced it a long time ago, and they keep pushing it back and pushing it. Yeah, it's Tom Clancy. It's made by Ubisoft. Whatever. My dick be soft. Whatever.
Yeah, that.
The ones that keep pushing their fucking games back all the time. I think they were having frame rate issues or something. Cause online you can find some leaked alpha footage and it looks really bad. Like the texture packs aren't loading right. It looks pretty bad. And like they tried to come out and explain, well, that's a pre-alpha. It's not the final game. And this one they did show like a game demo a long time ago at last year's E3, I think. And it looked really sexy. And that one, I'm pretty sure, is smoke and mirrors based on that pre-alpha. But again, I don't know. This one is like Homefront. Chaotic, fucking after the world's ending and there's terrorists and everyone's just fending for themselves. It looks cool. I don't really get what the story is behind it. There's a division of dudes. The Division is an upcoming open-world third-person shooter role-playing video game with survival elements. Okay, that's super specific. it looks good in the trailers and stuff, but we haven't seen much. They've just been working on it for several years and only showed us like a 5-minute sneak peek of gameplay. So I don't know about this one. And again, this one, Amazon says 2015. They don't know when. December 31st, 2015. Do you think there is any room even left in the first-person shooter world?
Yeah. I mean, it's just that my thing is they need to. There needs to be some more original stuff coming out. I mean, that's kind of like, you know, okay, Mortal Kombat 10, you know, or, you know, Battlefield, or, you know, 27, and Call of Duty 84, you know.
Yeah.
Or, you know, Halo 5, you know, there's...
Yeah. So you don't mind new shooters coming out, but like a new IP, a totally new story, new, different way to play.
Well, it doesn't even necessarily have to be a different way to play.
Yeah.
I mean, they can, you know, the way I've kind of harped on, you know, Destiny being another MMO, you know, we can have another first-person shooter and, you know, just tell me a different story. Let me play in a different world. You know, just, you know, it doesn't... The mechanics can be the same because, we know, these types of games have been around for so long that you know, you really can't mechanically change anything and it be, you know, amazingly new. But, you know, you can tell a different story and I would be just as happy with it, you know.
Hmm.
You know, that's the way I feel about Destiny. Destiny's another MMO, but it tells a cool story. You know?
I mean, one could argue that Destiny tells no story. Well, Q, some things happened.
Yeah, just a thing or two.
We no longer have half an hour of what episode we just recorded.
That's a little depressing.
So what we're going to do, we're going to give you a little snippet of what you missed in that half hour. I mean, there was jokes, there was fun times, there was Q talking about Warhammer and how excited he was. Q, if you want to go ahead and talk about Warhammer since you didn't get to, go ahead.
Well, no, it was just, you know, fuck, I feel like I've the rhythm is fucking gone. Like, it's like, God damn it. No, coming up sometime around, August, September, they're going to be releasing a new first person shooter for the Warhammer world. Stop laughing. This is so fucking hard.
I love how you're saying it like resentful though. Like, yeah, whatever. August, it's like a game is coming out and like fucking.
Well, I'm just really worried that if I talk any more about Warhammer on this podcast, we're going to lose more shit. So.
I think it's the Warhammer curse.
Yeah. So, Warhammer Space Hulk, go check it out. It's about the Dark Angels and Tyranids. It's really awesome.
God damn it, Q. I feel like I need to punch a pillow or possibly a baby. This is an idea I've had for a while. The greatest video game ever made, Punch a Baby, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's your $1 million idea for when you are extremely stressed or you got fucked over by a computer or your boss or whatever. Punch a Baby video game. Clear your history. Or just clear the podcast.
Yeah, that works too. We do it all the time.
Listen to my new podcast, which I didn't delete. Storios, soon to be known as the Oreo Show. Listen to that. Right now it's on Pigspot. It's on whatever you listen to this, however you're listening to this. You've already know Storios is up there. I'm moving it to its own thing, its own channel, whatever. Clear your history. Facebook.com/PigsPod. Go fuck yourselves. Bye.
Bye.